anymore. Nice to see some of us here today. It is a bit wet and miserable out there, I know, but anyway, let's begin. We gather in the name of the one who creates, the one who liberates, and the one who heals.
Amen.
May the glory of the three in one be with you.
And also with you.
From mist and darkness, from restful waters,
God gathers us.
From health and sickness, from plenty and poverty,
God gathers us.
From highlands and valleys, from fields and cities,
God gathers us.
To a feast, to a banquet, to life eternal,
God gathers us.
So come to this space and be still. Come with an open mind and a giving heart. Come to give thanks. Come to experience the presence of God. Come just as you are. Come and know that you are loved. So if you're able to and you'd like to stand, we'll do our first bit of music. Peace. We come to God as one from whom no secrets are hidden, to ask for forgiveness and peace, as we say together,
Lord God, in our sin we have avoided your call. Our love for you is like a morning cloud, like a dew that goes away early. Have mercy on us, deliver us from judgment, bind up our wounds and
love of God bring you back to themselves, forgive you your sins, and assure you of their eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us bow our heads for the covenant. God of unnatural wisdom, you gave us Jesus our Rabbi to question the roles we play, the submissions we enforce. May your living truth free us from the exile of exclusion, and make us all learners and doers of your word, through Jesus Christ, teacher and liberator. Amen. So if you'd like to stand again, and we'll have our next hymn, Gentle Silence.
Sends the Advocate as my representative, that is, the Holy Spirit. He will teach you everything and will remind you of everything I have told you. I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. The Gospel of Jesus.
Thanks be to God.
Shalom.
Shalom.
There was a man living in the Middle East. He was a very rich man. He had fields of wheat and all things like that. But we know he was a really rich man because he had not three, not six, not nine, not 12, not 15, but 17 camels. And they weren't your common or garden camels. Oh no. These were specially well-bred racing camels. You know, the BMWs of today. Well, everything was going well for the rich man. But of course, as with everything, got older and decided he'd better make a will. So he made a will and he said in his will, to my son, I give one half of my wealth. To my grandson, I give one third of my wealth. To my nephew, his sister's son, I give one ninth of my wealth. Well, fair enough, a decent enough will and testament. But of course, the day came when the rich man died. And his last will and testament came into being. Well, the three young men arrived. Well, one of them wasn't quite so young. They arrived and divided everything up. Everything was smashing, it was fine. Everybody looked until they came to the camels. Right, said the son, half of them are mine. Well, half of 17 is a little bit awkward, isn't it? Eight and a half camels. Oh dear. Not good. They would have to have killed one camel. Then the grandson came and said, what about my third? And he thought, that's five and two thirds camels. Still not very good. And then, of course, the nephew, his sister's member, he comes and demands his, which is one and eight-ninths camel. Oh dear. Well, they could not work it out what they were going to do with these camels. The camels, of course, were completely oblivious, you know, standing there looking down their noses. You know why camels look down their noses, don't you? Because they know the unknown name of God. Or at least that's what the theory says. Anyway. And these three fellows were getting more and more and more het up. They wanted their share. They got so het up that they started collecting all their friends together and all their servants and everybody else and getting weapons or what have you. And they were going to fight over these camels. Three armies on a plane. Now, living in the middle of this plain was a poor man. Now, we know he was a poor man because he only had one camel, and a right mangy camel it was. Remember, these are all beautiful, you know, the Formula Ones of the ancient world, you know, absolutely. This thing was mangy, moth-eaten, and used to spit in gay abandon in you. But as you can well imagine, the poor man did not want these three armies fighting where he was, because he wasn't going to do very well out of it at all, was he? So he went to them and said, look, I've got a camel, if it's any use to you. Now that was actually a big thing to give up, this one camel. But anyway, we've now got 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18 camels. And they started to divide them up this time. Well said, remember, the son wanted half of them. Half of 18 is 9. So the son wanders off with 9 camels. Remember the grandson? He wanted a third. Third of 18 is 6. So he goes off with 6 camels. And you remember the nephew, the sister's son? He wanted a ninth. So a ninth of 18 is 2. Which left 1 mangy old camel who went back to his owner and spat at him. And because he had given the one thing he had, the camel, the man had stopped the fight, stopped the war that was going to go on. So blessed are the peacemakers. Shalom.
So when you've got your head around the mathematics of that one, you'd like to stand to affirm our faith.
children of God, we celebrate the beauty and individual worth of all creation. So we pray together.
We believe in God, who created each of us, who breathed into us our uniqueness, who delights in who we are and what we can still become. We believe in the love of God, who laughs with us in our joy, who cries with us in our pain, who wants all creation to seek peace, reconciliation, and love for each other. We believe in the justice of God as revealed in Scripture, and through the lives of prophets of yesterday and today. God alone created us. We are not alone. God loves us. Nothing will separate us from the love of God.
Be sit for our prayers. And we start off our prayers with a short poem. Remembrance Sunday. Lest we forget, poppies dance in poignant cascade. A field of red that colours our eyes, fragile and delicate, of sorrow and loss, a sad reminder of the dreadful cost. Remember the imprint of sacrificed lives, the hope of the future, peace in our lives, the cost of freedom by every life lost, young and old and those in between, of courage and bravery, of fear disguised. We remember with pride the loss of their lives. Remember the imprint of sacrificed lives. The hope for the future of peace in our lives. Red poppies remind in poignant disguise. The longing for peace of hope in our eyes. Begin in the heart. Remember with me. Let it all begin with me. Now is a time of silence in which we can move into a time of prayer. If you wish to light a candle, say a prayer, or sit in silence.
I pray and I invite your prayers for my friend who is in a wheelchair with cerebral palsy and is feeling overwhelmed by a number of difficulties to do with her disability benefits and other problems. I pray for those that have come back from battles, whether it be from long ago or recent, but they can't get on with their lives because they are battling with their mental health. I pray for peace.
Into your hands, O God, we safely place all those for whom we pray, trusting in your love, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So, if you're able, would you like to stand for peace? The peace of the Trinity is uproar and colour, dissent and challenge, wandering and exile, invitation and inclusion, drawing our bodies and spirits into the riotous harmony of God. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So let's offer each other a sign of God's peace. While we're standing, we sing our next song, which is Make Me a Channel of Your Peace.
There is injury, your heart and gold.
Blessed are you, God of the universe, as you provide bread to sustain us and wine to gladden our hearts, so may our sharing at this table draw us into closer communion with you, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer.
Blessed be God forever.
God is here.
God's Spirit is with us.
Blessed be the names of love.
Lift us our hearts to grace.
We open our hands in thanks.
Our song is to God.
God of all living, we praise you for your vast and varied creation, for the light of sun, moon, and stars, for the high mountains and the low valleys, for the sea, the surging waves and the mighty winds, for water in dry places, and for the green earth. We thank you that we can marvel and delight in the world around us. You made us in your image, and give us breath, thought, and speech. Therefore, we raise our voices and join the company of heaven in your praise. Holy, 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 holy Lord,
God of our heart, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Your works proclaim your glory, O God. In every age and from every place, you call a pilgrim people to seek your face. In the fullness of time, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ. Journeying through Galilee, he called people to follow his way, seeking first your justice and peace. And with every step, he brought your mercy and healing love to those along the road. And at his journey's end, stretched out his arms on a cross to bear our pain and free us from fear. On the night that he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup, and again gave him thanks. He gave it to them, to his disciples, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Therefore, Lord Jesus, we proclaim your death on the cross of Calvary. We celebrate your glorious resurrection and rejoice in the outputting and pouring of the Holy Spirit. In our beginning, at our beginning, the Spirit formed us in our mother's womb, and in our earthly life travels with us. May the Spirit rest upon this bread and cup, that we may be nourished with God, with Christ's being and life, sustained as members of his body and strengthened in our pilgrimage. As we say together, come upon us, enlightening Spirit,
invigorate, inspire, and guide us.
So triune God, may all who gather at this table be made one in Christ. Know your welcome and receive a foretaste of the heavenly banquet. Draw your whole church throughout the world into your kingdom, where we may rejoice forever in your presence and worship you, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, in songs of everlasting praise.
Blessed be God, and glory be yours forever and ever.
Please be seated. Rejoicing in the presence of God among us, let us pray as Jesus has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our
Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
As the grains of wheat are scattered, and then harvested to make one loaf, though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. So gather your church into the unity of your kingdom. All are welcome to take communion. In Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Now we sing our final hymn, one of my favourites, I must be honest. Be Thou My Vision. Two. Evermore.
Amen.
Amen.
feast is now ended, let us depart in peace. Remember the words we have said and the acts we have done. The work of the world lies before us. Accomplish justice with grace.